Neha and Frank with our Fast News segment. I'll look at some news in more detail. The suicide of a Congress councillor from Nangloi in West Delhi last night has sent out shockwaves. 26-year-old Satyam Yadav was found hanging from the ceiling fan of a bedroom on Thursday. Her 1.5-year-old daughter had been strangulated. She's declared dead at a hospital later. After Satyam Yadav's family filed a complaint of dowry harassment, the police has filed a case of murder against the in-laws. Her husband has been arrested now.
यहाँ पर सत्यम यादव जो कि सिटिंग काउंसलर है 43 वार्ड नंबर का है नांगलोई जाट का है इन्होंने सुसाइड किया हुआ ऊपर से चुन्नी हैंड में बांधा हुआ है दाढ़ी के गले में बांधा हुआ है इनकी 1.5 साल की बच्ची वंशिका ये भी यहाँ पर बेड में पड़ी हुई थी हॉस्पिटल में ले गए थे सत्यभामा हॉस्पिटल में वहाँ पर ब्रॉड डेड डिक्लेयर हुई है पोस्टमार्टम के बाद पता चलेगा 7 साल के नीचे नीचे इनकी वो शादीशुदा है सो एसजीएमएन
Now the councillor's brother has also alleged that his sister was pushed into politics by her father-in-law who is a small-time Congress leader.
ऐसे लालची लोग हैं कि इन्होंने मेरी बहन को छोड़ा ही नहीं है जान से मार दिया
आपको ये बताइए सत्यम ने बताया था कभी कि वो हमेशा परेशान
वो हमेशा फोन पे बात करती थी और बोलती थी कि आप लोगों ने भैया कार नहीं दी है इन्होंने अपने पैसे से खरीद कर जो कर दिया मोहल्ले वालों को बदनामी हो रही है इनको
नोट भी मिलेगा
कोई सुसाइड नोट जब सुसाइड करा ही नहीं है तो सुसाइड कहां से हो जाएगी और तो उसकी बैटरी चार्जर तक नहीं सलवट नहीं बदली हुई है बिल्कुल ऐसे उसे जो ना लटका गया आराम तो मैं तो कल सीएम से मिल रहा हूँ और उनसे जांच करूंगा कि इसको जो ना इसकी जांच कराई जाए दिल्ली में कांग्रेस के पार्षद की हत्या वंशिका की दहेज के लिए मार दी गई छोटी मोटी बात नहीं है
Alright, we have with us Priyank Tripathi, our correspondent, and also Ranjana Kumari, director of the Center for Social Research with us. Priyank, first of all, what action is the police taking besides arresting the husband of the councillor? How are they pursuing this case forward now?
See, Juchad, today in the morning only the Delhi police arrested Pawan Yadav, who was husband of Satyam Yadav, because the case was totally against him. The family of Satyam Yadav have alleged that this is a case, it's a simple case of dowry death, because they were continuously pressurizing Satyam's family to give them 10 lakh cash and a Honda City car. This is what the allegation was. This was the statement which the family members had given to the Delhi police. On the basis of that, Jujhar, this matter was further on given to the SDM since this death happened within 7 years of the marriage. That's why an inquiry held by SDM of that area is being conducted in this case. On the basis of the preliminary inquiry report which was submitted to the Delhi police by the SDM, the Delhi police later on arrested Pawan Yadav today morning. And after that, Jujhar, Pawan Yadav was sent to judicial custody for 14 days. The Delhi police is now searching for other family members of Pawan Yadav as well because they are also an accused in this case. Although the Delhi police...
Where are the in-laws right now?
See, Jujhar, all the in-laws are on the run because since the moment the Delhi police started to search for them, they went absconding. And right now, the police is still searching for them. The Delhi police is telling us, the sources
right.
are telling us that maybe they have some detail about the family members, but they are saying that very soon they'll be able to catch them.
Right. Priyank, stay over there. We'll just come back to you. Ranjana Kumari, I mean, this is a really shocking case because, one, it's not just a dowry debt. Two, is happening in a political family in Delhi. And three, the in-laws, apart from pressuring her for dowry, have also been pressuring her, apparently, to get into politics, to extend their interest. She had to become a councillor, get elected. What do you make of this? It's almost bizarre.
Yes, Juzar, I think this is really speaks volumes about the way women are treated in our society. Look at her, she was elected councillor, she didn't want to enter politics, she was forced, she can't choose what she wants to do in life, and also for greed for money, they have killed her. I think the greed for a car, a life of a woman has become, you know, something comparable to just if you they don't get a car, the girl will be killed. I mean, this is, you know, the state of affairs in the country where how can any woman feel safe? How can, you know, after marrying a daughter, father can sleep in peace, that, you know, after giving so much and spending so much money in organizing the marriage, then, you know, sending day in and out, we are getting such cases where women come walk into our office and they come and tell us about how they have been tortured, harassed, taunted mentally, psychologically, physically, you know, so much of violence has been inflicted on them for want of dowry. I think the husband has been arrested. They must ensure that police must ensure. We are happy that husband got arrested. Now they should ensure that the family members get arrested. And also people should watch it carefully, because, you know, a lot of people have started making noise in our society that dowry law, women are misusing the law, dowry law is overdoing it. Look at this. Look at an elected women representative. If she is, we are talking about political empowerment of women all the time. We are saying that you empower women politically, they will be able to deal with violence on them and on their children and family. But look at this. I mean, what kind of example is this before women of our country, that whatever you may be, whosoever you may be, violence inflicted goes beyond any limit, to the extent that finally the woman has to give away her life. What system are we living in? Is anybody thinking about that, you know, not only implement the law very effectively, very, very stringently, but also somehow, some way we have to eradicate this really menacing system of...
Yeah, but Ranjana, you would be perfectly aware
so many women, over 8,000 women last year lost their life.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you'd be perfectly aware that there are hundreds of dowry deaths in this country. Yeah. There are many, many more, you know, dowry harassment cases, cases of brutal torture against women as well. Now, the laws have become more stringent. But what is the problem? Why is this, you know, why don't the figures really come down in terms of the number of dowry harassment and deaths that are being reported every year? What is the problem then in the system?
Well, Jujhar, the problem is from both the sides. Side of the, there is greed, so much greed growing with all the consumerism around. Every middle class family, lower middle class, every family wants to get everything for free in one go. And if they get it in the name of marriage and in the name of dowry in marriage, these kind of negotiations happen. Now that the law is there, people are negotiating much more brutally, in the sense that they want everything before the marriage has solemnized, so that nobody will get to know what kind of a money and things transacted. We get cases where people have demanded throughout the, you know, the first child is born, then there is something in their family. So it's a continuous coercion and harassment of the bride's side, where there will be all the time more and more dowry wanted. And from the groom's side, it is the greed which never stops. And girls' parents think that they are buying a good life for their girl, but they should not try to buy the life. Let the girl get educated, have a career, let her get into, you know, choose her future, give her a choice to make, you know, decisions about her future, join her in encouraging her, making her take mature decision, but don't push her into marriages where these kind of, you know, fate they will meet because of dowry. 8,000 girls were killed just last year.
Right.
What kind of a society are we living in?
Right.
And why don't parents understand that giving dowry is equally a crime? Taking dowry in any case is a crime.
All right, we've got to leave it over there, but we will continue to track this case as the police carry on the investigations and look for the in-laws of this dead counselor. In the meantime, Ranjana Kumari and Priyank Tripathi, thank you for joining us. Now, the UK has developed an aid of 280 million.